men, women, brothers and sisters, I come to you in the name of the Lord today. I come to you with a message of hope, a message of love, a message of salvation. I come to you with a message of help, a message of hopes, a message that will bless your life today. I come to you with the bread of heaven that will feed you till you won't want no more. I come to you with the well of water springing up into everlasting life. I come to you with the word from the Lord today for your life. My brother, my sister, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whomsoever believeth on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. It's time now in the last day for every man and every woman, every boy and every girl to seek God today. Don't turn to the wickedness of the world, but yet turn to the love and the life of Jesus Christ. I have a message for you today as one crying out in the wilderness to tell you that Jesus loves you today. Jesus loves you. He has no respect to person. Jesus loves every man and every woman, every boy and every girl. He sent into this world his love, his peace, his joy, his mercy and grace. My brother, my sister, understand that God's grace is sufficient. You might not know which way to go right now. You might not know which way to turn. But I tell you in the name of Jesus, turn and look to the hills from whence cometh help. Help cometh from the Lord. He said that the devil come to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But Jesus said, I come that you may have life and that you may have it more abundantly. I come as a servant of the Lord, knowing that some of you might not have made it to the house of the Lord. Some of you may not have a ride to get to the house. Some of you have been talked about so bad you're scared to go to the house. Some of you have done some things that you're afraid to face people. But yet God sent me as a servant to bring his word to you wherever you may be, wherever predicament you may be in, wherever area of life that you might be right now, God is reaching out to you today. No matter if you're in the gutters of the streets, in the dark pens of the prisons, in the dark life in your mind, whether you are one that is a criminal or not, God is seeking you today. God is sending his love to you today, whether you're homeless or not. The Spirit of the Lord is seeking you today. Whether you are one who have given up on life, let me bring you another life. That's through being born again. Born of the water and of the Spirit. Jesus says that when you're born of the water and of the Spirit, you shall be made new. In the newness of your mind, though people might know you from the way you were in the streets, the way you were in your past life, the way you were in your sins, I bring you life and more abundantly. Let me tell you something now. In the scripture in Luke, 14th chapter, beginning at the 16th verse, the Bible says that there was a man who had servants. One day he prepared a great meal and a supper for some people who was already invited. The Bible says that he sent the servant out to tell the people that is invited that he had bid to come. And the word of God said that all three gave excuses. One said, tell the master that I can't make it because now I bought a property. I bought some ground that I must attend to. Let me tell you, there's many people whom God had blessed, they forgot. They forgot God. Some of them cried as long as they didn't have no grounds, long as they didn't have no house, long as they didn't have no place to stay. They cried out unto God. God sent the servant to tell them, come on into the house where the feast of the Lord is. And they told him, tell the Lord, or tell that master, I'm busy right now. They told him that I bought some ground I must attend to. Another one said, I bought 5 oxen and I'm too busy now. And that's in representation. An ox was used. An ox was used to till the ground. What's going on, my brother? All right, brother. The oxen was used to get the grounds ready for the crop. And so it is today, some people have too much business now that they forgot about the house of the Lord. They forgot about the kingdom of God that's at hand. Hear the message today. Another one said, I'm married now. I found a wife now, I'm too busy. I have a wife now and I need to go attend to her. And see, it's the same thing with us today when we didn't have no spouse, when we didn't have no one to love us. We cried out to the Lord when we was in need. Now that God has given us someone to love us, now that God has appeased your crying tears, some of us have forgotten him and given excuses why we shouldn't live according to God. Why we shouldn't reverence him. Why we shouldn't call on his name. Why we shouldn't clap our hands in the name of the Lord. Why we shouldn't proclaim the name of Jesus. These three gave excuses. So the servant came in and told the Lord, he said, the people gave excuses. He said, well, this time, go to the poor, go to the maimed, go to the halt and the weary, and tell them to come in. When the servant went out, he cried out into the streets. When the Lord had told him to go, when he cried out, the word of the Lord says that some of the old people came in. But when they came in, the servant said, Lord, the house is still not full. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit has to say today. When the servant came in, the Lord became upset and said, this time, go into the highways and the hedges and compel men to come. Tell all of those who are in need, who are on drugs, those who don't know which way to go, those who feeling empty on the inside, those who don't know, who don't have necessities, those who are feeling down, those who are on drugs, those who are on alcohol, those who are being tortured and tormented by the devil, those who are homeless, those who don't have no might, those who are weak, those who are homeless, those who are hopeless. Listen, if you come into the house, if you come into the house and see the feast of the Lord, God has a way and an answer for you. That table that God has prepared, the house that he talked about, is not that of brick and mortar. House, the way the supper of the Lord is, that he told men to come, is not that of brick and mortar. The house that he speak about is coming into the fold, into the church of God, becoming a church today. Becoming a people who are healed, delivered, and made free. For those who the Son set free, they are free indeed. I bring you this message today. A message of love, my brothers. Message of love, my sisters. God has no respect to person. Doesn't matter what ethnicity, what country, what religion, what predicament, what devil is on your life, what area of life you're in. If you, for one time right now, say within yourself, Lord, I hear your words. Let your words come into my heart today. Fill me up today, Lord. Fill my cup. Let it overflow. If you, for a few seconds, will say, God, forgive me. I repent of my sins today. Lord, I tried everything in the streets. I tried everything that I was big enough to do. And those things couldn't make me free. But Lord, I want to be free. My friend, my brothers, some plant and some water, but God gives the increase. I don't come today as one that have arrived. Neither do I come as one who has salvation to give. But I'm just one crying out in the wilderness. I'm just a messenger. I'm just a servant of the Lord today. To bring you the bread of life. To bring you that water that once you drink of it, you will never thirst again. To bring you the peace of the Lord today. Some of you say, how can I receive this? How can I be made free when I've been on drugs for years? Some of you say, how can I be made free? Because I've been locked up and I'm more than the third strike. I've been in prison for 15 years and I can't find a job. And I'm still going to checking into my probational office. Some of you say, how can I be saved after the devious and dark sins that I've done in my life? Some of you say, how can God save me when I'm a man, a wretch undone? How can God save me when I have so many enemies in the inside? Well, let me tell you something. There's nothing too hard for God. God can save any man no matter where he is. There was a man that had a legion of demons. And a legion of demons was in this man. Where? Anytime they put fetters or chains upon him, he was able to break them with no problem. But when he met Jesus, Jesus broke the chains in his life. Until you try Jesus, when you try him, when you turn to Jesus, he will break the chains in your life. And I'm not talking about a physical chain. I'm talking about a spiritual chain in your life. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit has to say to the church. Brothers and sisters, do not turn your back to Jesus. Do not walk by without telling the Lord, I need you. Do not walk by without receiving the Spirit of the Lord.